Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Conquest. In the last episode, we basically completed the fleet. There it is. We got a ton of ships, almost all dreadnoughts. So we took care of the Cardassians, so now we gotta take care of all this stuff up here. We basically conquered all of the south, so. I really want to demonstrate the wormhole generator, but I don't think we're going to do it on this run of the campaign mode. Virus emitter might be helpful at some point, but I'm not sure. This guy might be powerful, but I'm not sure. Alright, I want to guard this, but I also want this planet, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back and forth, so... Let's do that, shall we? They're really gonna do this to us, aren't they? Alright, instant mode. Okay, we all survived. That's nice. Yeah, okay. Basically, I always do 100% in terms of, like, I have to get all of the planets. So, I'm a little OCD with that. Okay, this guy can, like... take care of over there. This guy can go over here, maybe? I don't know. I'm not sure what I should do. We definitely have to use a special weapon, though. Because, priming special weapon. We have... If we don't use it, then we're gonna waste research point things, so... these guys are way stronger, so let's use it on them. Yeah, and let's take care of this last green planet we got going on. And, we could do, like, arcade mode, but it's really not worth it. We're just gonna do this. Whoa, that guy's got 16 health? Since when? That's not good. Oh well. Let's go over here. Alright. Anyways, we've got a level up. Let's see, what do we got? 80% attacking, and... That's it. Okay. That's all we get. That's all you get, and you don't get upset. I always hate those stupid sayings. Where it's just like, okay, you don't have to rhyme at me, sir. You don't have to rhyme. It's quite unnecessary. There are just things that, like, people either abuse or overuse, like phrases and stuff, and it's just incredibly annoying. Like, one of them is, like, life isn't fair, and it's like, this is unrelated to everything and anything that is happening as of right now. Like, I could be talking about something completely unrelated, and they'll be like, well, life isn't fair, and I'm like, shut up! That has nothing to do with it. But, anyways, now that I've rambled on, we're gonna go over here. We're gonna go over here and, what are we gonna do? We're gonna fight these guys. These guys have done nothing. I don't think they've attacked a single fleet. They've done nothing but fight neutral planets. And I mean, if this was real life, I'd just sort of leave them alone. But, this is Conquest. Galactic Conquest. So, we have to fight them. And Lag City. Okay. You know, if I had a game company, I would totally be like, let's make Star Trek Conquest 2. I have, like, so many, like, good ideas for, like, what there could be. That can be your question of the episode that I only do, like, every, like, 5 episodes. What do you think would be in a sequel? Even though I can guarantee there's no sequel. I know there's not gonna be a sequel because it's not like this game sold well or anything. And this was made by, Bethesda? I think they still make games and stuff, but I don't think they're doing so well financially, I don't think, so... They probably are not looking to make a Star Trek game. Especially after how bad that last one turned out. I thought maybe it could have been cool, but then I saw, like, all the reviews on it. And normally I don't, like, care about reviews, because the reviews is just what someone else thinks. But, yeah, there's a ton of glitches in that game, and I don't want to deal with that nonsense. The only game that's filled with glitches that I'm like, this is okay, is, Superman 64, which is a really fun game. It's fun for, like, reasons that it shouldn't be. It's just sort of, like, bad, so it's fun. In a weird way, it's not so bad, it's not, like, frustratingly bad. It's just sort of, like, funny bad, I guess. But, yeah. I have Superman 64. I kinda wanna Let's Play that, maybe. I don't know. Rotan John's already doing that, everyone's just gonna call me a copycat. Even if I do kinda like the game. Also, flying through rings, that stuff is easy, man. Just, everyone's like, it's the hardest thing ever. And I've given people the controller, I'm like, okay, it's pretty simple. Just fly through the rings, and like, they can't do it, and I don't know why. Because I have zero problems doing that. Like, for real. So, I don't know. Oh, there's so much lag. Ugh. Man, look at this. Look at this. Is this, like, on purpose? Is this a joke? Is this faux reels? I don't know. There's hardly anything going on the screen right now. Is my Wii just, like, dying? You know, I have to transfer my Wii data over to my Wii U. I have to do that for my, my high scores on Sin and Punishment. Or Sin and Punishment 2, I guess. High scores on the first game doesn't matter because you can't upload them to online leaderboards or nothing. Which would be great if you could, because I would probably get, pretty high up there. Because I can actually beat it on hard mode, unlike most people who can't even beat it on easy mode. Not really bragging, I'm just saying, but whatever. But yeah, like, I have, like, really high scores on Sin and Punishment 2, and I can't upload them because the Nintendo Wii servers are down, but I can connect if I have, if I use the Wii U. So, I have to use the Wii U in Wii mode to do, like, online stuff. Unfortunately. So, that's sort of just how it works. All my Wii games work with the Wii U, so it doesn't matter to me, I suppose. The only thing is GameCube, but, upgrade available. That's actually fine. Like, the GameCube stuff, just no problem. Because I got an adapter so I can use GameCube controllers, so I am fine with all that. My fleet looks like it's doing alright. We'll just plop one of those down there. And, oh, that one's got a thing. This is one that we recently conquered, so we'll just put one of those there. We need this. And, put that there. Alright, so, alright, everyone's doing fine here. This can continue, this can continue. I think this is the one that had, like, 19 health last time. It's doing a little better. So. And here we got Deep Space Nine. Wait a second. How come I don't remember going to Deep Space Nine on the Federation playthrough? We did, didn't we? We had to have. There's no way we didn't, but I don't remember it. This is awkward in many ways. Oh well. Anyways, this is Deep Space Nine. So, yeah, let's go tag it over. Normally I'd probably skip over this little part, but it's Deep Space Nine. So we can't deny Deep Space Nine, because... yeah. Because we can't. Sometimes it feels like I'm the only one who likes Deep Space Nine, like the show, at all. I think it was pretty cool. How far back are we? Okay, we destroyed it. I was like, are we even moving? What was I saying? Yeah, like, so many people don't like it because they're like, Star Trek's about exploration and such, and it has, like, some exploration, but not... We lost a ship. Well, thank you, sir, for getting rid of that ship. Kind of. I kind of thank you. Kind of. Because it was, like, a really weak ship, so... we'll replace it. Did we... destroy the thing? And there we go. This is pretty easy. Pretty self-explanatory. And such. We only got... one turret left. Oh man. Look at all this. Look at all this destruction! Alright. It's weird how the ships always, like, turn in some direction and they always do it simultaneously. Like, what's in that direction? What's telling them to do that in their programming? I don't know. It's kind of weird. Anyways, we got 80% attacking, and there we go. And we rebuilt Deep Space Nine. Cursor was kind of weird there for a second. And because we rebuilt it, we get to make another ship. Ships are pretty cheap now, although we don't really need them to be cheap now, but whatever. We can actually move one more, so we're probably going to do that. This can move two. This fleet here can handle everything. I'm going to send this fleet over here if it's all set. Yeah, this is good enough. Tis good enough. We're just going to take care of this one. I'm gonna cut this out. You don't need to see this. Alright, there we go. We're all good. So, oh, we didn't get a level up. Oh well. Up. There we go. One, one, one. Alright, what do we got going on here? Alright, that's all set. I think we can attack now. I think we're good. Alright. We'll fight you, sir. You only got, what, like four ships? Not really a problem. You know, the more I think about it, like, the more I'm like, there needs to be a sequel. I have, like, I don't know, like a mental list of, like, games that need sequels. This is one of them. So... yeah, this is definitely one of them. Then there's, like, Custom Robo. You guys ever play Custom Robo? I haven't, but I really want to because it looks really, really good. And, yeah, it looks really good. And I think we need a sequel, Nintendo. Nintendo, you should do something about it. Get, like, Retro Studios to do it, maybe. After they do another Metroid, because they need to do another Metroid. Because let's just face it, Metroid is the most important out of anything that you do, Nintendo. It's like Metroid and Zelda, those are the most important. Ah! Almost broke my shields. Alright, we got one guy left. Sir, you can go down in dignity. Oh, he's shooting at me, shooting my face. You don't have to shoot my face. Well, you do if you want to kill me. I suppose. Oh, we got a level up. That probably means, two moves per turn? Yeah, nice. Alright, that guy's there. We can, What just happened? I don't know if you guys saw it, but, like, everything went blank. We're gonna pretend that didn't happen. can move that there. yeah, that was really weird. This is really, really weird. Oh, man, we're running out of time, man. We're running out of time. Let's do this thing. What the fudge and nutters? What? Everything keeps going blank. Stop that. Alright, so we're just gonna attack this one guy before we end the episode. Oh, thank goodness this is short. Good. Because we're already up to 20 minutes on the recording. Minus a couple minutes of that one thing we did. Who knows? Who knows how long this is, anyways. We're actually gonna set everything to attack mode so we can get this over quickly. And come on. Through the fire, through the flames! Yeah! Destroy that guy quick. Let's do this quick. Can't have the episode be too long. Actually, I could technically just speed up clips and, oh man, taking some heavy damage. These guys are finally... Either I'm acting reckless or these guys are acting like they should on hard mode, aka slightly decent. Alright, so we got one less ship to attack with, which is unfortunate, but... Well, let's get rid of these turrets while we're over here so we don't have to go look for them later. That would help. I might have to cut out one of the battles if this is too long, because I don't want to split up the episode. Because, I don't know, it feels kind of weird. Sir? Okay, this better not be my capture card, like, just breaking on me, because I swear, if my capture card breaks, I am not buying anything from Diamond Multimedia again. I'm going straight to Elgato. Just straight to them. For all my capture card needs. So, maybe it's my Wii. Maybe the Wii is having a problem. I don't know. Anyways, we're gonna end the turn, is what I was kind of trying to say. Can we hurry up? Please? Oh, seriously? You don't attack the guy who's right there. What? Who programmed the AI? Man, that's pretty... Like, I could program AI better than that, and I don't even, like... do that stuff. Upgrade available. Like, oh man. Anyways, all strength. That would be nice. Anyways, thank you all for watching. And let's meet back next time where we finish Klingon mode and show off the bonus for whatever you, for when you beat Klingon mode. So I'll see you guys then.